Again to community focus. How are you, John?
How are you, John? I'm good.
That's about. The weather's not the best.
No, it isn't. But we had a good run of it now, John. So run, no, can't complain.
Yeah. And you're on holidays shortly as well.
Next week.
Yeah. Oh, hopefully it clears up. Yeah. I heard there's a monsoon and everything now.
Oh, yeah. Well, hopefully it will stay that way because I'm painting the house. So.
Tornado. Yeah. You name it, snow. John, today we're on about literacy and numeracy in Ireland. 1 in 6 adults struggle with understanding basic written text, and 1 in 4 struggle with doing simple maths. I didn't realise it was that.
Yeah, I suppose, like, we run literacy classes here through the core skills program.
Yeah, very good, actually.
ETB provides. So we do one-to-ones, but we do other stuff. It's not just that. But the one-to-ones we do are in a private room where the tutor does one-to-one tuition with people of varying degrees of, competency. So somebody might have 0 skill and they can't recognize basic, letters and that, or somebody might just struggle with putting those together. So she'll work, the tutor we have, will work with them. And that's done on a referral basis. So if anybody knows anyone or if somebody themselves would like a bit of help, and because there's a taboo around it and embarrassment, yeah, and it shouldn't, yeah, be, but there is. Well, we will do this. We can set that up for them, and it's done very discreetly.
Well, I have to say, there's a great room there for them, and it's discreet. And people go in there one to one with the tutor. And in fairness, no one takes any notice here of what's going on.
No, you can't see into the room. No one knows where they're going.
It's great,
So, I mean, that's not the only way we do it. We do various degrees of literacy, like there's digital literacy as well, which would be the basic computers, because there's still people out there who probably wouldn't know how to switch on a computer, plug it in, the basics. And, you can't get by these days without having some knowledge of tech, a little bit even, how it works.
We were just talking about that, John, before I come on, over being cocooned in a factory job for years, driving a forklift.
Yeah.
As I told you, when I went back to school for a year, I couldn't turn on the computers, the Apple Macs. I didn't know how to turn them on.
Well, they're a different ballgame altogether, but I know what you're saying.
Still, I hadn't an idea at all. And that's a great thing, because now everything's computerized.
Yeah.
Everything's emails. CVs have to be sent by email.
You're fine with it now,
Fine. That's from working in here now and doing my courses here and everything, which was great. Yeah. Uplift to me, and I've no fear of the computer now.
Yeah, I mean, digital literacy is important. There's also numerical. So, I mean, we do cookery classes, and believe it or not, this literacy can be derived from the cookery classes because the weights, so to say you need a pound of sugar, or you need 10 kg or 10 grams of this, that's all literacy, and that's all developing mathematical skills, and some people don't even have that. You hear the old stories working years ago, a fella going to the canteen with the newspaper rolled up under his arm, but he can't read it. It's just he has just that fear. Or I left my glasses at home constantly.
Yeah.
Which is sad. But back, I know from experience that my mother was she was a literacy tutor with the VITAS program, and I know the struggles personally in the family as well, that people just fell through the cracks. People that would have had years ago might have had a small learning difficulty. They might have, they just were passed over when they were left there, and it was, oh, you can't learn it, or we won't work with you, and there could have been an underlying reason. And they would have carried that to
the rest of their days.
And then would have got on with the job that they do every day. And you'd be surprised that when you do something on rote and you're kind of doing it every day, you know what to do. You don't need to read the instructions because you know what to do. And they just carry it, and it's something, it weighs heavily on them, I think.
I think so. I think it would. Even going into a shop, you're going for the same things all the time because you're familiar with it.
Yeah.
You're afraid if someone asks you a question or hands something to you to read. My grandmother was illiterate.
Yeah.
As well, and a lot of the time back then, days was true back in the 50s, 40s, 30s. It was true with death in the family. Maybe one of the parents could have passed, and the eldest child usually, eldest girl.
Would have to stay home from school and start rails. And unfortunately, they slipped through the cracks.
And secondary school then had to be paid for. And, I certainly grew up in a family where my mother wouldn't have been able to afford it. And she educated herself later as an adult.
Yeah, we fair play, John.
So I could see firsthand the positive effects it has. And there's certain sections of our society where it's kind of, the statistics would be higher, like the travelling community.
Yeah.
where, you know, I suppose traditionally there's a mistrust of the
That's education right. Don't system. Get a chance, yeah.
And you see that change now. I noticed there's traveler ladies there got their degrees recently. I think it was with NUI Galway.
Very good. Very good job.
And it's usually sociology or something like that, which is something I would have done in college.
Yeah.
And so there is a change there and a willingness to learn.
Trying to break the molds.
Trying to break the mold. Yeah, because I guarantee you, you know, literacy, never, like seeing a book on the shelf and never being able to know what's in it, or a magazine and just being only looking at it. But that's, you know, you think that doesn't happen, but it does.
It does. Yeah.
It does. It does. Look, there's a couple of, like the ETV is someone we work with. We work with them all the time. We work with the Core Skills Program. Lorraine Markham is the Core Skills Coordinator up in the ETV. And we will kind of help kind of put together programs that we think would benefit our locality, because we know the people we deal with, and we know they might be illiterate, but there might be literacy issues. So we would put together like basic computers. We do that.
That's what I started on myself.
It's a level two.
Yeah,
it starts off with you put the plug in the back of the computer and literally right. switch it on, and then you move up the internet skills level three. You might learn how to use an email. And it's that kind of thing. But also now with the cookery, our lovely plug in our kitchen now, John. But we got a beautiful new kitchen, a training kitchen.
It's great, John.
A community kitchen. And we're going to be doing those classes in there through the literacy program too.
Very good.
Along with the one-to-ones, which we spoke about earlier. So that's someone we work with very closely with. Now, we do other stuff with the literacy, even mindfulness.
Yeah.
I believe.
Yeah.
Self-care, all that kind of stuff is linked. So, yeah, the ETB would be a great support to us in that.
And is there other agencies around, John, that we have one here, National Adults Literacy Agency?
Yeah, NALA.
I've never actually heard.
NALA would be a more of a national organisation. Like the LCETB would be, you know, Limerick and Clare based.
Yeah.
But the ETB is across, but that'd be our own localised one. Yeah, NALA would be the National Adult Literacy Agency. And they've got, like, they're the ones, the statistics now. They gather all the data. So it's 1 in 6, as you said earlier, John, Irish adults are at below level one. At this level, that means a person is unable to understand basic written information. They might be able to sign their name, but they mightn't be able to make out the word signature before it on the form. So 25% are 1 in 4 Irish adults. This is shockingly high.
Yeah.
Are probably at or below level one for numeracy. So they wouldn't be able to, you know, simple maths, calculations.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, in any job.
You need.
Yeah.
You do.
Even, you know, a job that you think you might get away with. Numerical kind of calculations are needed. So that's all done from the Central Statistics Office. I suppose NALA, what they mean by literacy is it's considered to be the ability to read and write in the past. But today, I suppose, it's changed to reflect the changes in society and the skills needed by individuals to kind of fully integrate themselves into society. So it involves listening, speaking, reading, writing, numeracy, and using everyday technology like smartphones, and being able to Google stuff and to handle information. And I suppose it's active listening. I mean, by listening, being able to understand and comprehend.
Yeah, yeah. Well, especially with the smartphones and the amount of stuff on it that people are missing out on, even just going buying something simple that you can't get in Limerick or you can't get in Ireland online, you know, just the enjoyment of doing that. Unfortunately, people miss out on that.
Yeah.
True. 9 times out of 10 is probably not their own fault, as you said. I'm a good bit older than you. When I was going to school, there was 40 in our class.
Yeah.
In primary school. So if you fell through the cracks there, the teacher hadn't time to...
Yeah.
You know, you were sitting in a section good. Okay. And then... So-called people that weren't the best were
there was almost no psychology to the learning. It was like you either learn it or you don't, or you're not.
There was no in between.
We look at now,
Which is a good thing, John, which is that's a great thing.
It's a very good thing.
You know, it's that's what Ireland is really caught up with a lot of places as well, that we have these likes of places that you know, with the numeracy and literacy, that it's that bad. Is it true, John? Do people say, no, this is probably an excuse, if you're bad at literacy, you're good at numeracy? I think that's probably just an old wives kind of tale.
I don't think there's anyone bad at literacy. I think it's just, it's an unlearned skill.
Yeah.
I think every, like, you know, dyslexia is one, right? Dyslexia is just, you see kind of your B's and D's backwards and it's hard to put things together and it's confusing for people. And I know now this is how proactive they're in school. If you have dyslexia in school, a child is often given an iPad.
Which is
great. It's easier because you can type it or you can speak to it. And so I don't think so. I just think it's the skill hasn't been.
Yeah, unfortunately, the willpower is there, but unfortunately, circumstances have determined what that person.
They were skipped over because they had dyslexia. Dyslexia wouldn't have even been diagnosed ASD, autism, mildly or whatever, and they were just left there. And it was a case of they weren't able, and they were given the job. That didn't require much education. And
that's the truth, you know.
So, you know, it's sad, but now we're being proactive about it. But it will still happen because I suppose really we still see younger people with literacy issues. So it's not just the older way of educating, and now we've got the 50, 60-year-olds coming in that were skipped over. There's still, and that could be from a lack of parenting structure at home, you know. Encouragement
is a big thing, I think, especially with young people these days. Well, we all needed encouragement even when we were younger, but it wasn't the done thing back then.
It still happens, and maybe just hoping, you know, get them out of school, get them earning money. I don't know, some people don't prioritize education, they just don't. Now, I think we do, as you're a parent, I'm a parent, we prioritize it for our kids, But, you know, not everyone feels the same way, I suppose.
The other day, just the funny thing about it, John, we were talking to a lady that attends the classes here, and she was a former teacher. And she was on about, because she's getting, Shamak inside is doing a few things with her computer and stuff, and she's a small bit computer literate.
Illiterate.
And she just said the art of writing with the young kids, that's what she's worried about.
Yeah.
The art of being able to put your thoughts down on a piece of paper. Yeah. She says, through the style, are we losing that through the computer age?
Possibly. You know, the way the texts are on R, A-R-E.
All shorthands.
That's probably got a negative effect on it.
Yeah.
But I think there was a study done recently that that's not so much of a bad thing. Because it's, you know, there's still, you know, to be honest, the phone is spelling, if you know, anyway.
Well, that's the truth,
The minute you type in something wrong, if it's close enough, it corrects it. Yeah, but look, you can't get away from digital.
You have to move. Yeah, you have to move as you said, John, there's many reasons why people struggle with reading, writing, and working with numbers. Some may have left school early, which we touched on. Others may have found learning irrelevant to their needs. In Ireland, nearly 30% of the workforce has only a junior certificate or less, which was myself. Intercept in my day, and 10% are only primary level or no formal qualifications at all. So that is a small bit frightening.
Yeah.
That people were kind of pushed on to get off the table. People hadn't got the money back then, as you'll have to start earning your crust, you know, when you got to a certain age.
We have a more protective social welfare system now, whereas then it was like people literally started. And now we have these kind of safety nets there for people to protect the most vulnerable people in society, which is a very important thing. Then again, a lot of people consider there has to be a happy medium.
They're on the bread line as well, yeah.
You know, you do want people to work. But,
It has to be kind of, as you said, a happy medium.
But I do think it's a good thing to identify and protect the most vulnerable.
It just says here as well, John, sorry, just on Ireland rates 15 out of 24 countries for its literacy.
Yeah.
England is 17.8%, Poland 18.8%, Germany 19%, Northern Ireland 19.6%, Japan 6.1%, Finland 10.6%, and they were all the lowest proportions of adults at or below level 1. That's frightening.
The Finland one is interesting in that Finland don't do homework. Finland do stuff like, I think kids kind of go to start at 7, and they're very much into the work-life balance. And I suppose there's a lot of studies, and I suppose there are educators might disagree with me there, but they do feel that homework has no benefit to children.
Hmm.
And I'd be kind of, that's a theory I could understand
in
some way. So that's interesting. It's just that in Auckland and in Japan, then again, I believe in Japan, there's not a very healthy work-life balance, and the same in Korea.
Yeah, work long hours.
Koreans have a very high suicide rate because they just, they work 50, 60 hours a week.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's always chasing.
Yeah.
What is the goal, though? You know, it's
Japan or Korea, where even if the man is working in the city, he stays in the city and do small little compounds, overnight to go back into work to follow him. Then
you're living
to work. Yeah.
And that's not right. And I suppose the Americans follow that route, don't they?
They do, yeah.
Luckily, we're part of the EU and we have this.
We have this bit of protection there, yeah,
So. And, you know, we can see the benefits of it ourselves.
Like. But. You touched on the ETB board there as well a minute ago, John. I bypassed this one. Sorry, this is my fault. We jumped above. People don't understand the ETB. Could you just give a small bit about? I wouldn't understand it myself.
Yeah, the ETB are all across the country. Ours is the Limerick and Clare Education Training Board. And we're what's known as a community partner, which means we've signed up to basically deliver ETB-funded classes. And I mean funded, they pay for the tutors. And we deliver certain classes to match the needs of our area. And the wants, I suppose. Like when I say wants and needs, I suppose the needs are to get people basic qualifications that can help them kind of improve employability and just social integration and all that kind of stuff. But the wants then could be community education classes because people want to learn how to make Easter bonnet hats, as you know, John.
Yeah,
we all wore them there.
Yeah, yeah.
When we done them,
we did.
And you know, I suppose it's there's a social aspect to it and there's also a training aspect to it, and we're very aware of both. We deliver the literacy classes, we deliver mental health kind of classes, like we done a mental health first aid class there not so long ago.
That's right, we did that. Very enjoyable class.
But we also do the community education stuff, which could be anything from yoga to art to we did stuff about learning to make your own will. We do Irish, we celebrate our own language and culture. And they have supported us through that. The ETB are a fabulous, fabulous statutory agency, and you know, we're delighted to be in partnership with them, and we shall continue to do so because really they do understand what communities need with regard to education, because we do provide that link for somebody to do something with us and then suddenly go into full-time education. Because you can put your toe in the water with us and go, do you know what that is for me?
Yeah,
and we keep it, you know yourself, it's formal enough in that we have a proper class structure here, but we do like to keep it informal. We have the crack with people. We like to have, you know, we like a good atmosphere when people come in. So that gets people in a nice place then when they said, all right, maybe I could do this full time and then kind of follow their dreams, which, you know, we are that link and, you know, the ETB support us in being that.
And do they support everyone else around all the other community centres, John, that there is classes going on?
They do. They're in family resource centres across Limerick. They're in, like, the schools would have them for parent courses, and Bernardo's organisations like that's Adapt House would have classes. You become a community partner and then you apply for hours. That's how it works. So once you're a community partner and you show that you have the same ethos, the same kind of idea on education delivery, then they'll work with you.
Well, that's great, John.
We have had great support. Well, we have a good track record here, and you know, they have supported us in a lot of things and continue to do so. And the next range of stuff we're going to be doing is, you know, the cookery classes, John.
Well, with the new kitchen below and everything, John, it's you know, it's even some of the people were in yesterday and just doing a bit of arts, doing their own kind of arts.
Yeah, the club. We started the club this year,
And they were delighted with it.
The cookery is going to be great because we're going to be doing baking. We're going to be, we do a thing called one pot cooking, and the thought behind that is, I suppose it's for people living on their own that might think, oh, takeaway is a good, you know, when you spend 20 quid in a takeaway, you could actually get about 3 or 4 meals if you know what you're cooking.
And help your meals.
It's better for you. Yeah. You know what you're putting into the pot. Yeah. So they call it one pot cooking, meaning it's not complicated.
Yeah.
You're not sauteing. Yeah. You know, you can do, you know, it depends how good you are, but you can provide a lovely meal, like a chowder or like a stew.
A meal that would fill you up, and that's good for you. Well, that's great, John. But so that's fair play to ETB. I hope that's any people are out there thinking of going back to community centres or to do courses, no matter where they are, stretching across Limerick or even parts of Clare or whoever's listening.
Even, like, John, if they want to contact us, even if it's not in our area, we'll forward them to
That's great.
We'd be happy to direct anyone.
Oh, that's great.
Toward that's the great. Local or the ETV themselves. Yeah.
No, that's brilliant. Thanks for explaining that, John, because I didn't know that that myself. No, you know, but it seems like we're going back to literacy again, that there seems to be a big influx of the government are really taking notice of the literacy kind of thing, especially Minister Simon Harris. Is he still mixed up the education, or is it Nora Foley's? I think she's over the schools.
She's over the schools.
Yeah.
I suppose in 2021, the in line with SULAS, the Adult Literacy for Life, was a 10-year strategy. So it was based around literacy, numeracy, and digital literacy, like we spoke of. And it aims to ensure that every adult has the necessary skills to fully engage in society and realize their potential. So it's a long-term strategy, or mid-term, depends on the way you look at it. But I suppose the commitments included increasing the number of learners engaging with literacy and language support by 20,000. So this is done by expanding the range of courses available. So I suppose the more choices you have, the more you pique
people interested.
I think we're all the same. We all learn better on something we enjoy.
If you're interested in, you take it in anyway.
You take it in.
If you're interested.
So they wanted to reduce the number of people, especially adults in Ireland, with unmet literacy needs from 18% to 7%. That's ambitious.
That's going to be a big drop now. Yeah.
But that would be
brilliant if they got
a fine achievement. And reduce the number of adults in Ireland with unmet numeracy needs from 25% to 12%. So that's another half and a bit. And reduce the share of adults in Ireland without basic digital skills from 47%, that's high, to 20%. Just like we provide something here, actually, John, know that links with this. Shamik, our IT guy, and we have a new lad now called Patrick, who's happy to work with people on a one-to-one basis that need some tuition, come in for an hour, book their time. The lads will go through all their needs, set up an email with them, all that kind of stuff. And we hope that will feed into a class now, because some people would want even that little bit before they do a class, and that's fine too. So, you know, we're playing our own kind of part in that, and that's a community IT kind of literacy thing we do here.
And it's great, John, because it really has taken off.
Yeah.
Even a few people that weren't going doing classes here from different parts of the city came down to get Shamak to have a look at the computers and things like that, and show them how to download, show them how to save stuff and the whole lot.
Even that's great. Purchase something. What am I buying? Some of these things.
Which you really are missing out on, you know, that enjoyment of, like, we're into music and things like that. Some of the music we're into, we can't get.
No.
In Ireland, you have to go online.
And
it's great to be able to find it. And and then you're looking forward for a couple of days to the comps.
Even opening a Spotify account, you know, the world is there for you.
And Spotify is brilliant.
Because you can't buy a CD in, like, you don't want to buy your CDs in the supermarket. You don't have record stores. You've seen what record. You go in this. The days of having 5, 6, 7, 8 music stores in Limerick are gone. So you have to engage with the digital.
Well, you know yourself years ago, you'd buy an album. You'd buy an album for two songs.
Yeah.
The rest of the songs weren't the best. Yeah. But you'd have to buy the album for the two songs. Now you set up your own Spotify playlist.
Yeah.
Pick out your own songs. Absolutely. And hours of enjoyment, you can have there, like, you know.
Absolutely.
You know, and plus, you should also then be listening to Limerick City Community Radio as well.
Of course, yeah.
On your phone if you can't get it on, if you're not in the Limerick region. We have to say that as well, John. But listen to us waffling on.
Actually, I think there's a thing online called Radio Garden, and it's an app of the world, and I think you can find all the radio channels of the world that have a frequency. And I think Limerick Community Radio can be accessed.
Oh, that's great. That's great, John.
You can go. It's great. You can go into any country and city and pick out a radio.
Oh, but
radio
that's
Garden. It's a free. Yeah. It's a free Windows.
And the best thing about that, especially online, John, there could be someone on the other side of the world listening.
Which
you know, your audience. Somebody used to live here, trying to keep up with, which a lot of people do with Limerick City Community Radio. A lot of people that have moved away.
Yeah.
With one or two of the presenters of other shows, they're willing to them, and they listen every day. And it's that bit of home comfort.
Connection
away from home. It is nice, John. Yeah. It is nice. You know,
you can't, the passion of volunteers is something that can't be understated.
No.
You know, and people that do this for no profit just enjoy doing it.
It's an enjoyment, John.
And, you know, there's no agenda to it. It's to do something you care about.
It's a fantastic hobby to have. You're doing well as well over the last couple of weeks for a person that would not talk into microphones before.
No, I have to plug it now.
Well, there you go. But you're doing great, John.
Why not?
You're doing great. it's a hobby at the end of the day, but you do get into it in a big way, you know, and it's great enjoyment. This half an hour of just sitting in a room, the way all your worries are left outside.
Get to pick a few tracks you like.
Get to pick a few tracks, or a music show and things like that, you know.
Every music lover wants to just
play
their music to everyone else anyway, so isn't it great?
Well, it must do. Maybe someday you come on the rock show and can do an hour of your music. And
don't push it now.
So John, fair play. 25 minutes already we've gone. So the show is really after flying. So John, fair play. So you've did a lot of research and you give a lot of information, John, on something that's a very, very important.
That's something we both worked around. We both understand.
It's very important, John, to especially with literacy and
we care about it. You see, this place is a core part of what
it's great. It's great, and a lot of the other centres around would be on the same level, but it's great for the literacy and getting people to say that they have some place to go, all in confidence.
Yeah,
don't be afraid.
Yeah.
Just call.
We'll look after you.
We look after you, and don't be worrying. And no one takes any notice. And it's not. There's nothing wrong with it. It's not a fault of anyone. Life throws up.
Compliments.
It's compliments.
That somebody can take those steps.
So, John, I'll leave you say goodbye this week.
Okay, John. Thanks very much, and goodbye. And we hope to see you again in 2 weeks' time.
La notte qui non torna più, dal giorno che sei andata via, ed il cielo ha smesso di giocare con le stelle, con la luna e le nuvole.